Check out this harmonica. Look at that. It's got all long reeds, blows and draws in every single hole. Okay, you can see they're all long reed slots. So I've actually tuned this one for some chords. You can see here's the standard comb, but you can see even though the comb chambers diminish as you go up to hole number 10, I'm still using all these long reeds everywhere. And the reason for that is that these are rear mounted draw reeds, and that means that they can work, a reed like that can work in a chamber like that. So it just gives you a whole lot of really interesting scope to take low notes and push them right up to hole number 10, all through the harp. Now, a chord, as most of you all know, takes, a proper chord takes at least three notes and normally four. So you've got your tonic, your third, your fifth, and then your tonic above, or it could be the seventh or the major seventh or whatever. In this case, I've made four note chords using two holes. So every two holes, that's two holes there, 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 I've got five different chords. Okay, hole number one here, I've got an F major chord. So I've got my tonic, my third, my fifth, and then my tonic, you know, my high tonic there. So here's what it sounds like. And these are all blow reeds, and the reason I can use a long use blow reeds is because they're front mounted reeds and they can fit inside these long comb chambers. So here we go. And I've also made a G major chord using the same length of reeds in holes numbers 3 and 4. So that's tonic, third, fifth, and tonic. So here's your G major chord. So that's a G, an F major. Okay, two chords. Now, once we get above hole number 4, you really have to swap to draw reeds if you want to use the long reeds. So in holes number 5 and 6, I've got a draw major chord. So I've constructed this one using notes from the low F harmonica. So that's a G, C, E, and G. So it's actually a chord with two fifths in it, but it sounds quite nice. Okay, so it's a C chord with a C, a tonic third, and a fifth below and a fifth above. So now I can play those three chords together. Okay, so that would sound even better if the covers were on the harp and it was, you know, being the reeds were being pressed down on the comb. But you can see even with just the adhesion of the differential adhesive gasket, you can play the harp enough to test out the chords and see if they sound good. Okay, let's move on up. So in hole number, that's 5 and 6, 7 and 8, I've got a D major chord using notes from the G harp. And this has got a similar voicing to the C, which I just played. So here's your C. And the D. Now these are pretty straight ahead chords. I mean, they're just majors so far. But you could actually make all sorts of really unusual chords if you wanted to. Diminished, augmented, you know, basically anything you can think of, you could actually make a harp with the kind of chords that you want. But this is just as a demonstration to show, you know, what's possible. So now let's move up to the final two holes. This is holes number 9 and 10. And I think I've got, what have I got here? I think it might be a B flat minor. So now I'll just use some of my fingers to damp out some of the reeds. So here's the full chord. If I take out the third, more like a sort of power chord. Now I'll just use my thumb to close off the ones on the bottom here. Okay, and you know, I can do that with all the other chords. Obviously you can't do this when the covers are on, though maybe I should invent some kind of little damping thing that comes through the covers and you could damp out the reeds. That's not a bad idea, maybe I'll do that. But anyway, I hope you get the idea. So from a standard, 10-hole diatonic comb, which has got, shorter chambers at the top, longer at the bottom, you can actually put all long reeds on your harp and create nice, rich, low chords everywhere. I've actually got plans to make combs which do have long chambers everywhere, and also longer combs and all sorts of other permutations. But this is just one little example of what's possible with the modular reed harmonica using the advanced harmonica builder table on my website. So I hope this gets your brain cells ticking over, and starts you imagining breaking away from the confines of the traditional harmonica construction. Basically, there's a huge number of mad possibilities out there, and I'm hoping that a few of you will take this opportunity and sort of construct some absolutely crazy new harmonicas. Okay, bye for now.